Thinking of taking a cruise on the Silver Dawn of Silversea Cruise Line? Wondering what kind of food they have? What the restaurants are? Hold on, let's talk about this. Hi, this is Jack with Luxury Cruise Tips. Let's talk about what they have to eat on the Silver Dawn of Silversea. So I want to break down what your dining options are by time of day. So we get up in the morning. First thing most people want is breakfast. You have a couple options for breakfast. Of course, you have room service. You can order that with your butler. You can put the card out the night before. You can just give your butler a call. The nice thing about room service on Silversea is they set the cabin up nicely, white linens, they course it. It's just a great experience. So you should definitely try it, maybe set it up on your balcony. So you have breakfast is room service as an option. Number two is La Terraza, which during breakfast is a buffet with an omelet station and a smoothie station. A lot of great choices, and their pastries are delicious. Your other option is if you want a more formal, you can go down to the main dining room at Lantide. And again, that's a coursed menu by menu items. You order off a menu, they'll serve it to you. My experience in that is it takes a little bit of time. So if you're in a rush to get on a tour, you may want to give yourself 45 minutes to an hour. It was not fast. Your other option is Arts Cafe, which I think is just great if you want your fancy coffees or anything. They always have pastries, some fruits, some smoothies pre-made. It's a great option if you want to grab and go and take something with you. When we look at lunch, you have a lot of options. So let's again start. You can do room service at lunch. You can check out your TV. There's a full room service menu on the TV. They have options from the various restaurants available all day. Get chicken wings, you can get a burger from the grill, just a lot of great options. And again, you can work with your butler on that. So let's again start with options. So one option is on deck four, you can do Atlantide. Open most days, full menu, multi-course. Again, give yourself about 45 minutes to an hour. Great options. I would say there's two or three salads, two or three appetizers, maybe five to six entrees. Menu seems to change pretty much every day. Also on deck four, which is really neat, is Kayasaki, which is a open for dinner restaurant with an extra charge, is sushi and ramen during lunch, and it's free. So if you like sushi, they have some set sushi items on the menu, but the sushi chefs there will customize sushi as long as they have the ingredients for you, and you can get some ramen. And again, the trick here is at lunchtime, it's free. Now we can go upstairs. La Terraza is open again for lunch. It is a buffet. There's also a station for dessert, which will blow your mind if you like sweets. There's also ice cream there for dessert, a separate station for gelato. And there's a walk station. They'll have custom things every day, one or two items that the chef will be making. And you work with your server and they'll bring it to your table. But you have a lot of options for lunch. Lunch will change every day. Now, if you go upstairs to the pool deck, you can go to the grill. The grill has pretty much the same menu every day. They may change one or two items. Certain days they may do a feature buffet. One day they did Mexican. One day they did a sausage fest. So again, things will change there. And then if you go up one more deck, go up to Spacanopoli, if you want the best pizza at sea, you can order there. Sit down, red wine, and again, with Silversea, again, remember, everything is included, so the wines, the alcohols, beers, you name it, it's available at any of the restaurants. Now, the other trick is, let's say you want some pizza, but you don't want to sit upstairs, you can actually sit at the grill and ask them to bring you the pizza menu and order things. Or if you do want pizza but you want a salad because they don't have salads on the menu, you can ask the server to bring a salad from downstairs at the grill for you. And your last option for lunch, for a light lunch, would be Arts Cafe. Again, because at the Arts Cafe they change things multiple times during the day, if you go down there they will have some pre-made sandwiches, some pre-made salads, they'll have some desserts, some fresh fruit. It seems to be relatively the same every day. But it's a great place to sit if you want to grab something quickly. Now let's look at dinner. So you have a lot of options at dinner. First option is room service again. It's a lot of fun. I would say try it. You can do it in your cabin. We actually had them set up our terrace, our balcony, veranda, and it was a lot of fun. And again, you have a lot of options that are on the main restaurant menus that you can have in your stateroom. So let's start in deck four. First thing is you have the salt kitchen. So salt kitchen basically starts two menus. So you have the right side menu, which is always available, and that is a bunch of dishes that is generally from the area. And you have a couple pages of options here. And then usually on the left side of the menu every day. On our cruising, which was a 15-day cruise, the chef told me he had 13 different menus for the left side. So they're usually either sourcing the ingredients locally, or it's a menu that he creates just for that given location. It's a lot of fun, a lot of good drinks. They'll have certain wines from that area as well. We saw some wines we like. We asked for them another day, and he said they only ordered enough. They ran out. Also on deck four, you have Atlantide. Atlantide, formal sit down. It is, to me, steaks and seafood. Multiple courses, great experience. And they have some of the best desserts. Don't miss the deconstructed lemon meringue pie and a lot of the ice creams. The next place you have on deck four will be Kaiyasaki. Kaiyasaki at dinner time in 2023 is Asian with a $60 fixed price per person surcharge. Did it twice. It was a lot of fun. The food is very good. The service is good. They have sake. They have beers and drinks that are more Asian. They had some scotches from Japan, which were a lot of fun to try. So that's Kaiyasaki. You should make your reservations for Kaiyasaki prior to boarding if you can, because it's small, or make them as soon as you can with your butler as soon as you board. Another option for dinner is if you want Italian, La Terrazza, which is buffet for breakfast and lunch, turns into a sit-down Italian for dinner. One of my favorites. Great salads. They have great bruschetta and a bread basket, which is hard not to eat, and olive oil on the table, and some of the best balsamic vinegar I've tasted. They also have a pasta course, which you can get as smalls, if you want them as a small pasta course, or you can get them with an entree, and if you want, you can add some protein, some shrimp or chicken or fish to them. They also have full menu of other entrees, some steak, some fishes, and some other items such as duck. Now that menu they tell me changes twice during a longer cruise. Every 7 days they change that. They were very, very similar. The dessert menu stayed almost exactly the same the whole time I was on, but I did see slight variations in that menu. They have a couple different wines at each restaurant, so the nice thing in La Terrazza, they do have some Italian Chiantes and Pinot Grigios. Again, if you like a bottle of wine wherever you are, comment to your server about that and ask him if he can have the butler get you a bottle, and they will bring it to your stateroom so you have it to enjoy when you're not at one of the restaurants. Another option for dinner is La Dame. La Dame does have an extra surcharge on the Silver Dawn. On the Silver Dawn, the surcharge was $60. It is a classical French meal. Service is impeccable. The place settings are beautiful. But please look at the menu before you go. What you may find is you don't like certain courses. We've done La Dame once. I didn't like a couple courses. I talked to the maitre d' before dining there, asked him if we can make some changes, and he said as long as we give him some notice a couple days before, they can see if they can work out some special things for me, which they did. It is something I would say is definitely worth the money. The wine is different, the glassware is different, and again, it is something you should make the reservation online prior to arriving for the cruise, because it is a smaller venue. Now, if you want something really informal, you can head upstairs to the grill, again, which is by reservation. People have heard about the grill called Hot Rocks at dinner. So what they do is they will bring you a stone. It's a steakhouse. They also have seafood. You will make your own dinner on the stone. I know it sounds strange if you haven't tried it, but again, they'll bring you the raw meat. They bring this hot rock and you just place it on the rock. They'll come and help you. It's very informal. They'll give you an apron to wear because it does splatter. They have great baked potatoes. It is outside by the pool. Now, they do have some heat lamps in case it's a cooler time. I've done this restaurant in the middle of the winter in a cooler climate, and it was fun, but we were wearing jackets. They gave us blankets, and they gave us the apron. On this last cruise, they just asked me on the dawn if I would like the chef to cook my steak for me, and I said yes, please, because he'll get it perfect. I did have problems cooking a thick fillet on the stone, so the chef did it perfectly. One of my other favorite options for dinner is Silver Note. Now, Silver Note is right on deck 7. It's truly a unique experience. They advertise it as a jazz dinner club, jazz supper club. What I would say is Silver Note is, it's a small venue, only open for dinner. There is typically a pianist and a vocalist doing some jazz and doing just updated medleys. I mean, the singing is beautiful. There's a bar in there. You have to make your reservations as soon as you can online. You can try to make them on the ship, but I really advise making them once you make your booking online. The plating is beautiful. I would say it's modern tapas. There's small plates. There's from sea, air, land. It's a real eclectic mix of things, but the plating is just beautiful. And again, the experience of the music, they'll typically couple sets during the night. The other thing is, if you're not even eating at Silver Note, you can still come into the lounge and there's a bar, and you can just sit at the bar and listen to the music. I find the bar gets pretty busy. Most of the tables are either two tops or four tops, but Silver Note is very unique and something you have to try. The other thing is the menu does not change. So if you're on a longer cruise, it's pretty much the same menu, but there's a lot of great options at Silver Note. Another option is Spacanopoli, the pizza restaurant, is open for dinner. Very informal again, if you don't want to get dressed up, even if it's a formal night at Hot Rocks. And for pizza, you do not have to get dressed up. Again, it is outside, it is covered, there are heat lamps. It is the same menu of pizza and calzones that you have during the day, but it is a great option. Now, Arts Cafe does not really have any dinner options, but they do have dessert options and chocolates. So you can always stop there if you want chocolate to be your appetizer prior to your dinner. Now, during the day, if for some reason you just are hungry and you need something in between meals, there are a couple places where you can have snacks. So pizza is typically open from at 11 in the morning till about 11 at night, so you can always stop by. Right there, you can also get gelato, and they have some toppings. Arts Cafe all day long changes what they serve. Room service is a great option. So I think if you're in the middle of a meal or if you're on an excursion, you come in between meals, you have a lot of options. You will not go hungry on your Silver Dawn cruise. So hopefully this dining guide is helpful for what you're going to have on Silver Dawn. Enjoy your cruise, enjoy the food, enjoy the alcohol, and thanks for watching my video.